As many of you will know, I've been researching and using a particular technology for early breast cancer detection for the last 10 years. This technology is called breast thermography. And I believe, based on all of my work, that it represents an unprecedented opportunity to change the game as regards to early breast cancer detection. Many of you will have seen an article published in the Sunday Mail in the beginning of July 2015, where there's a quote from Sarah Wollaston MP saying that breast thermography should be banned. Well, here's my view on that. First of all, that comment is not based on all of the scientific evidence. And secondly, my fear with politicians getting involved with this subject is that it will lead to a gross injustice, leading to women having the choice to seek an alternative to mammography removed from them. And I, as a responsible physician, I'm not going to sit back and watch or see that happen. I decided to write an article in response mainly to what was said in the Sunday Mail. And the response is really because I feel that what was said undermines my integrity as a doctor who's been offering women thermography for the last 10 years, and also other doctors who have been offering it as well, because they feel they're giving women a better deal. So the article was written really to give information to women and to empower women with this information so that they can make an informed choice. In this article, I talk about the scientific information, the up-to-date scientific information that has cast doubt on the effectiveness of mammography as a breast screening tool. I also talk about why the Swiss in April 2014 took the decision to ban screening mammography based on a review of all of the evidence. I talk about the reasons why mammography is not early detection. I also go on in the article to say why non-radiation based thermography does give us an unprecedented opportunity to change the game with breast cancer detection. And also in the article, I justify, based on all of this scientific evidence and my own experience, why breast thermography really deserves its place in breast cancer screening alongside the other screening tools. I believe that there is misinformation about there, and I believe politicians should be very careful about their comments with regards to incomplete information, because as I've said earlier, I think it's a potential injustice, and it could potentially remove a valuable screening tool from access to women who are, by the way, choosing to have thermography rather than mammography. So how should we react to that? Should we remove a screening tool that women themselves are choosing to access because they've informed themselves about mammography? As a responsible physician and someone who has offered thermography from my practice for 10 years, as I said, I'm not prepared to just sit quiet on this. Does there need to be more research in thermal imaging? Of course. We need to continue to do research in order to validate what we know thus far. But there is enough published information to justify breast thermography's use, at least adjunctively. By that I mean alongside the other screening tools. Every woman has the right to choose based on all of the scientific information. And that's what I've tried to convey in the article that I've written. Ultimately, I believe it will be women joining forces and having a voice together that change the status quo with breast screening. Pass this information on to your mothers, your daughters, your sisters, all your female relatives, so that the truth will give them the freedom to choose.